All right, let's get going here. So yeah, last night I was able to get the whole sky in, and now tonight I am gonna start with the ground, and then if possible get to the grain elevators. For the ground, we're gonna use a bunch of yellows. We're gonna use some cadmium yellow, some raw sienna, some yellow ochre, a bunch of different kinds here, so will be good. I have no idea how much I'm gonna need, so start with a bit here and mark the ones that I need to do. This darkest color. Okay. Here. All right, I think that's all the darkest ones, so we'll start with those. And then work our way through. I might raise this up just a little bit. Down so much. Dark color, I might be good just to do one layer. We'll put it up on the edge there just for a second so we can get this bottom on. Hi, Elaine. I'm doing good. How are you doing? Oh, you gotta glitch your computer. Maybe it's on my end. You never know. Oh yeah, thanks for commenting on those. I was able to take a look at some of your artwork. I enjoyed all the different, I guess the different kinds of scenes you are able to do, and the style that you have. It was cool. Oh, on Microsoft Edge, I've got a Mac, so I either use Safari or Google Chrome. I don't use the Firefox or Microsoft Edge. Oh, nice. When you try your wood burning, you'll have to post some of it on Instagram so we can see it. Oh, I love Macs. I guess Macs aren't really for gaming, but yeah, it's good for other things. Oh yeah, GarageBand. I haven't been on GarageBand in quite a while, but it's a cool app for sure. No, well, growing up, I played the piano and the guitar, but I haven't done anything with music for a long time. Oh, yeah. Well, it's good to have a few hobbies now that you can enjoy with your time now. Yeah, I definitely don't do as much of it as I would like, but you just make do with what you can and get it in a couple hours once the baby's in bed. And I appreciate us. I'll tell you some prints. So I either scan or take high quality photographs of my artwork, and then I send those files to a printer. I get most of my prints done by a company out of Quebec City right now. A 10 by 16. I can't remember. I'll check here. The closest they would have is like a 12 by 16, and a 12 by 16, yeah, is $9 Canadian, so that would be maybe about $6 American. Yeah, there's a few originals I would have a hard time parting with. Yeah, super reasonable. And like the 8x10s are under $4 Canadian, so that would be probably under $3 American. And they're super good quality. I've been really happy with every print they've done for me. and they ship it right to the customer for you in Canada or the US, either place. I'm not sure if they do scanning for you. They might, but you might be better off finding somewhere local that would take high quality photos for you or scan your paintings for you. Then you just upload the file. Yeah, let me just type it in here. Or just search it on Google, the G Clay Factory. I've been ordering prints through them for almost 2 years now. And yeah, they're awesome. Yeah, just note that all the prices. G Clay, it's a type of print. They're more professional quality than just like a photo print. Yeah, G Clay. No, the whole name of the company is the G Clay Factory. G Clay itself is a term that other art companies use. You know, it's a term for a specific type of art print. And so they're just known as the G Clay Factory. Okay, we're gonna start marking in here some of these darker yellows. To be a little bit darker. I'll see when it dries what it looks like. I thought I missed a burn line for a second, but nope. We're good. Okay, where am I here? So this one has to make this a little bit darker. Oh, great. I'm glad you found them. Right now, I've got a mixture of, I guess I probably could just use yellow ochre. It's a mixture of raw sienna and cadmium yellow medium. But I've got some yellow ochre here as well. That would probably do the trick for what I'm looking for. Let's try a little bit out of just out of the tube here and see what we got. It's similar. It's not quite bright enough, the yellow ochre, that for what I would like. All right, I think I got all of these spots marked. What I did forget is this one needs to be a bit darker side too. Okay. Now those things might be dark enough. Yeah, well, I'm looking at my phone because I've just looking at old ones that I've done of this one, because I've done this one honestly probably 7 or 8 times. So just to make sure that my colors match with the other ones, then I just look back at old ones on my phone, just because, yeah, like I advertise as made to order, and so I have pictures of the old ones up, and so then I know that the customer wants the colors to be the same, and so I always just, yeah, look at the old one for reference to make sure I'm matching those colors all right. Oh yeah, these ones will be plenty dark enough here. And these ones might need 2 layers here. That's okay. Turn on some music here. Had to let my headphones charge a little bit. They were dead from last night. Oh yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, they're I forgot that they did that. That's what I did first too. I just ordered a sample pack, and yeah, they send you just a little one of each of the different kinds, and then you get a feel for them. And I still use those when I go to markets and stuff. I have those samples with me, and so if people want to see the different types of prints that I offer, then I don't have to have like a bunch in stock there. I can just have those samples, and they can feel them and then decide which kind they would like, and then order it from that. So the sample pack is very useful, and I've even had them send me a second one too, and they did. Yeah, no problems. Oh, excuse me. For this color, I did cadmium yellow medium with raw sienna. She is 10 months old now. Oh yeah, she's saying "dad, dad" a lot, and she's started to walk the last few weeks here. And you're in the insurance industry. I'm a junior high teacher, math and science. Although my major in university was French, but I'm not teaching it. I do teach some art classes as well, though, so that's fun. Teaching is fun. I enjoy it. I mean, there are hard days and there's extra work after the school day too, but no, it's good. I mean, teenagers are teenagers, especially younger teenagers, but overall, the kids at my school are all pretty good. I'm in a good place. Yeah, we've got things pretty babified right now. Trying to make it so she can't get into stuff, or the things that she can get into are safe. Yeah, pots and pans and Tupperware. Yep, wooden spoons, spatulas, any of that kind of stuff. Seriously, they do. ACF paintings. I'm glad you could join us today. I missed you the other night. And Elaine, it's true. I mean, that's why we've got a bunch of small things for her to unwrap, because then she'll enjoy unwrapping them more than playing with the stuff inside. Yeah. It's fun to be able to talk to people while I'm on, so I enjoy it. CF, are you working on anything tonight? Or are you just relaxing again? Oh, nice. Yeah, I need to do a major cleanup of my area here too soon. Yeah, no kidding. When things are cleaner, I feel way more motivated as well. I usually keep it pretty clean, but these last few weeks here have been pretty hectic. I can't imagine how expensive they are. I'll stick with my paints for now. Oof, yeah, that is expensive. Hey, no worries. I was actually just thinking this is what I want, these kind of live streams to be like, for people to just come in and chat about things, talk about art. Even if I don't have anything to add because I don't work with pastels, that's totally fine with me. Yeah, if this can be another place for people just to come in and chat, another way to connect for people, it's awesome. Especially right now with everything going on. That's cool. I have to look into that. Yeah. Oh yeah, it's been a long time since I've seen that one, but yeah, I have seen it. What part of the US are you from, CF? California, nice. Can't say I've ever been there, but one day hopefully. I need to check out both of your channels still. Just out of curiosity, how did you both come across my channel? You wanted a landscape tutorial, and I almost a year and a half. You've been subscribed to my channel for almost a year and a half. That's pretty cool. And Elena came up as a recommendation. Oh, I'm glad I did. That's cool. So did you see one of my wood burning videos first? Is that what you did? What happened? I forgot this one up here. Cool. That's really cool. I'm glad you watched it and stuck around. Oh yeah. Yeah, I haven't really done much other than wood burning in the last year, to be honest, so that makes sense. I've had a painting of a deer. Well, two deers butting heads that I've been wanting to do. I've got it all drawn out on a canvas, and I've probably had it drawn out for almost a year now. Nice, yeah. Mean, I think your mistakes don't define you is definitely a good thing for any artists, right? Yeah, no, I understand. Sometimes they have to just sit on the side for a while and until you get the right motivation and inspiration to work on things. Yeah, I'm sure there's quite a few paintings like that. I think a lot of time we get stuck, thinking that we have to be producing paintings so often because there are some people that do or whatever, but we all just create at our own pace, and as long as we're, doing it because we enjoy it, I think that's the most important part. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Did either of you like do any formal education for art, or did you pick it up later as a hobby, or how did you come about creating artwork? Yeah, I totally understand what you're saying. I didn't do any formal art school, but that was one reason I didn't. I mean, I started painting once I was already in university, and I, wanted to continue with what I was studying, but I was, I didn't ever want to take any classes because I didn't want to be told what was right. I just wanted to kind of figure it out on my own. And if I like what I'm doing, that's the most important part. It doesn't matter exactly what other people think. I'm glad to see that you didn't stop creating art because of that. That would have been a shame. Oh yeah, that totally makes sense. But now you're at software development and web design. That's sweet. That's I do a little bit of web design myself. Nothing fancy, but if I was to choose a second path through post-secondary school, I think that kind of stuff would have been another area that I would have liked to have studied. Yeah, way to hack life. I'll have to look that one up too. Maybe I could listen to it while I'm working one of these nights here. Yeah, no, I hear what you're saying. Yeah, I'm usually listening to music or podcasts or, anything like that. What kind of podcast do you mainly listen to, CF? I'm always looking for good recommendations. CF, do you have any good recommendations for podcasts that you listen to? Oh, The Office Ladies. I listen to that one too. Yeah, I love The Office. It's fun hearing the backstory of those episodes. I haven't listened to it in a little while, though. I have to get back into it. I haven't listened to many podcasts at all in a while, to be honest. I listened to a couple this week, but it's been a while. Yeah, The Office is one of those shows I'll watch. Oh, I have watched many times, and I'm sure I will watch it again many times. I listen to one podcast called Beautiful Anonymous. It's run by the comedian Chris Gethard. He just has people call in and he'll just talk to a random stranger just for an hour. And they'll just talk about whatever. And there's actually some pretty interesting stories that come out of it. I quite enjoy listening to that one. I mean, like the content is pretty clean, except there's just, I mean, they do swear a little bit here and there. It's not terrible. They try not to, but it's pretty good. Yeah, some of the episodes are a little bit eerie, but there's some really interesting ones, really good stories. I listened to it a lot back in the springtime when I was commuting for my teaching job, and so I'd listen to it on the road all the time. But now that I'm able to walk to my work, I don't listen to it as often, unfortunately. The name of the podcast is Beautiful Anonymous. Yeah, we are teaching online right now. For the last couple of weeks, I've just been teaching online from the school. But as of this next week, before Christmas holidays, we're supposed to just teach online from home. So I'll just be staying home for the next week here teaching online. That's why I need to clean up my studio space, because that's where I'm going to be teaching from. So I gotta move my painting stuff. Whatever podcast app you use. On my phone, I use an app called Podcast Addict, and that's where I can find it. But there's a bunch of different podcast apps depending on just the type of phone you have, or I think you can even find them on the computer too. If you have a Mac, just on music on the iTunes, there's a podcast section you can look them up to. It's in that closet. Yeah, I'm just using a cadmium yellow light now, actually, for this last for these last lighter ones. It doesn't look quite as light on the camera as what it looks like in real life here. Nice. Oh, yeah, your dog chewed them up. You need to get some new ones. Yeah, I've just got these wireless ones that I use. They work pretty good. I just got them off Amazon for like 20 bucks a few years ago, and I've been using them ever since. Oh, nice. That's fun. All right, well, I think that's gonna do it for tonight. It's been a couple hours, but I don't want to stop your guys' conversation though either. I'm planning to be on tomorrow night to hopefully finish those three up. Hopefully, I'll be on tomorrow night, and we'll get those done. If you want to join again tomorrow evening, probably around the same time, around 7:30 Mountain Standard Time. So I think that's 8:30 Central Time and 6:30 Pacific Time. So if you guys want to join in again, I'd love to continue to chat with you, hear about life in different parts. And yeah. Thanks again for joining. We'll talk to you guys later.